Hi everyone and welcome to a new video. This time I have a Lenovo X1 Carbon Gen 2. I bought this for very little at an auction. It was part of a lot called laptop components and came with a screen, battery and bottom cover detached. There was also an additional LCD and screen cable in the same lot, among some other non-related components. First tests with the laptop, which was pretty dirty, showed that it was turning on, but, as I kind of expected, nothing appeared on the LCD. Using the HDMI connector and an external screen, all looked fine. I tried to replace the LCD with a spare one from the box, but that would be too easy, and I got the same result. Looking closer, I noticed that the LCD was actually working, but that it was the LCD backlight which did not turn on. In daylight, you can see this as well on the recording. I was not sure, but it looked a bit strange to have two different LCD panels, both having the backlight broken. A broken cable could be an option as well, but I already replaced one of those. After a thorough search online, I came across this post. This one describes the exact same symptom as I have and the previous owner replacing the screen with the battery still connected, causing a fuse to blow, seems like a plausible explanation. The same thread mentions that F7 is the fuse which is probably responsible for this. It even came with a picture of the location of it on the motherboard. Unfortunately, that fuse is on the other side of the motherboard, so that means a complete disassembly in order to get access to it. But let's give this a try. First, I have to remove everything connected to the motherboard. Starting with the battery. Followed by the Wi-Fi and cellular antennas. Next up are the M.2 SSD. Cellular modem, and Wi-Fi card. Then we can remove the rest of the flat cables connected to the motherboard, for example for the keyboard, touchpad, external ports, touch bar, track point, etc. Time to unscrew the motherboard from the laptop case. Seems I did forget about some more connectors, like the one to the screen. And turned out I also missed a screw. After getting these removed, the motherboard could be removed from the case. A nice and tiny motherboard, really cool to see if you ask me. This small piece has everything on it, like the CPU, GPU and memory. On the back, we can find a CMOS battery and SIM card slot, so the fuse should be located nearby as we saw in the online photo. Let's remove the plastic protection and try to find the fuse. Here we have it, exactly as on the shared photo, F7. Not so easy to get a proper image of this, as it is really small. F7 is the second component from the bottom here, as marked on the board as well. Using my phone as a magnifier, you can see this a bit better. First, I will test if the fuse is really broken by doing a continuity test with my multimeter. We don't hear any beeping, so this means the fuse is broken. Just to be sure, I'm testing another fuse, which clearly has continuity. I'm pretty confident at this stage that the fuse got blown, but not sure that will be all it takes to fix the backlight. To repair it, or better, bypass, I will just connect the two ends with some solder. It's really too small to put in a jumper wire, especially with the equipment I have at hand. My soldering iron is really overkill for these tiny components, but looks like this worked. To be sure, let me test continuity again. That sounds better. Not the most clean job I did, but pretty sure it was the smallest ever. Time to reassemble and hope this worked. I start by inserting the motherboard in the case and fixing it. Then it's time to connect back all the cables that are needed at minimum. And, the moment of truth is here, testing if this worked. As I didn't put the battery back, I need to connect the adapter. Success! We have light! I honestly wasn't expecting this. Since I haven't put back the SSD, obviously it doesn't boot. But navigating through the BIOS setup seems to work fine. Now I can put back the rest of the components. Like the cellular modem. Wi-Fi card. An SSD, and go through the fiddling process of reconnecting the antennas. Unfortunately, the repair took longer than planned, so my battery died at this point. All I did more was to complete the assembly with the battery and back cover. And here we have it, the X1 Carbon Gen 2 with a working LCD backlight. It's been a few weeks ago that I did this repair, and all is working just fine. This is a nice and compact laptop. That concludes the video. Thanks a lot for watching, and if you liked this video, please put a thumbs up. If you like similar content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel for more of the same. Thanks again, and I really hope to see you back here soon.